Now that we introduced the basic concepts and usage of tensors, let's see how we can use concepts from linear algebra to encode certain things like the weighted sum more efficiently. So remember, the weighted sum here is computed by multiplying the inputs with the weights and then adding the bias unit. And we do this computation essentially for each individual training example. And here for reference is again the general form if we have m inputs and m weight parameters. Now, if I want to compute this weighted sum in Python, I can do it as follows using a Python list. So here I have one training example with two features and the two corresponding weights. So what I essentially do is I set my output to b, and then I loop over all the values xj and wj, multiply them and add them to the output. And then the result is this weighted sum, here in this case 13.42. If we ignore the bias unit for a moment and just look at the x and w values, we can actually express the weighted sum as a dot product between x and w. So if x and w are vectors, we can use a concept from linear algebra, which is called the dot product, to compute this weighted sum. So let's walk through this step by step. Again, imagine x is a vector from x1 to m, and w is a vector from w1 to wm. Now I'm adding a transpose operation here, which is not required, but it is somewhat useful to introduce it here because it will become more handy when we talk about matrix multiplication later. So what this transpose here does is it's transposing this column vector x into a row vector x transpose. But maybe if it's simpler, let's just think of x and w both as column vectors. So how the dot product computation works is that we are looking at each row in this pair of vectors, and for each row we compute the product, and then we are summing up these products. So now in order to compute the weighted sum of the perceptron in PyTorch, we can use the dot dot method to compute the dot product between x and w, and then add the bias unit to it. And you can see this is much more compact than our for loop in Python. Just for reference, side by side, on the left-hand side we have the PyTorch approach using the dot product, and on the right-hand side we have the plain Python approach just using a for loop. And yeah, as expected, the results are the same. As we saw, the dot product is slightly more compact than the vanilla Python version using the for loop. However, a bigger advantage of using the dot product is that it's actually faster, much faster than the for loop in Python. So in this case, we can use the dot product to improve our code efficiency. So the question is, how much faster? So let's do a quick benchmark and compare the plain Python version with the PyTorch version. Yeah, so to make this a little bit more realistic, let's use a slightly larger feature set here. So for x, I'm here creating a list consisting of 1000 numbers. Since we don't really care about the exact numbers, we use random numbers. And then correspondingly, we also have 1000 numbers for the weights. Yeah, so using the handy timeit function in a Jupyter notebook, I can then actually compute the runtime of this code. So in this case, the for loop would take 35.3 microseconds to run. Now let's compare this to the PyTorch dot product. So first we are converting the Python lists into PyTorch tensors. Yeah, and then we can use the timeit function in the Jupyter notebook again to compute the runtime of the PyTorch dot product. So in this case, the runtime of this dot product is 1.42 microseconds. And yeah, as we can see, if we compare the runtime in plain Python to the runtime of the dot product in PyTorch, there's a 25 times speed up, which is huge. So that's actually a good reason to replace Python for loops with dot products wherever we can. So everything we looked at in this video referred to the computation of the weighted sum corresponding to a single training example. However, in practice, in deep learning, we usually work with large data sets. So is there also a way we can speed up the computation of the outputs for all the training examples in our data set? And for that, we usually use matrix multiplication, and we will see how that looks like in the next video.